Gabriel Noach Holzberg was born in Israel in 1979. At 9 years old, he moved to New York with his family. At first, it was awkward, but it didn't take long for the shy, Hebrew-speaking kid to make his mark. In fifth grade, he won a study competition, learning 50 double-sided pages of Talmud by heart. On another occasion, he won an international learning contest, flying to Israel for the final round, which he won. Living in New York gave him the opportunity to meet with and learn from the Rebbe. Blessed with a prodigious mind, he excelled in his studies, regularly authoring Talmudic insights in academic publications. Rivka Rosenberg was born to her parents Shimon and Yehudit in Afula, Israel, in 1980. She was a lively girl, and she managed to be heard, even as the middle child in a family of 11. She'd often help those girls who'd fall behind in their studies, and she was very feisty. She spent her summers traveling to Jewish communities around the world, sharing her heritage. One summer was spent in Riga, Latvia. Decisive young woman that she was, she decided at a young age that she would devote her life to shlichus. In 2001, boy and girl were introduced. After a few meetings, they decided it was a match. Shortly after their marriage, they made the decision that so many of their peers, other young Chabad Lubavitch couples, had made. Heeding the Rebbe's call, they decided to leave their comfortable home and head out on shlichus. The posting they chose was further and more difficult than most. After a visit, they decided on Bombay, India. It wouldn't be easy, but they weren't looking for easy. Just before Hanukkah of 2003, they arrived in sprawling Bombay, the world's second most populous city. Their center was a small rented room in a 3-star downtown hotel. They gave Torah classes in the small space and served Shabbos meals, although there was no kitchen. It quickly became an open house for backpackers, travelers, business people, and of course, the 4,000 local members of the Indian Jewish community. Like their forefather Abraham thousands of years beforehand, who went to set up a tent to share food, drink, and his knowledge of the Creator in a spiritual wilderness, the couple served their fellow Jews, catering to their material and spiritual needs. They took their cue from their beloved Rebbe.
Was gefinzer bekatze tevel wenn er het kemol nicht nigze Они восхвалили независимость Израиля и стали вечны. Тим кунцем на штет ва афтел эр яхо комейхо ментне ве яхто от глибхом у ментле эр яхо нит дир ментне на дем цветен у комейхо се дар зайн пункт а зэве до хост лип жир.
Where would they get kosher food? Gabi would buy hundreds of live chickens each week and prepare them himself. Rifki would give classes for women and make them feel welcome and at home. Gabi, with his endearing smile, would put guests at ease. He officiated at weddings, brit milas, and bar mitzvahs. The price? Free. We're here for you, they would say with a smile. Their activities grew and grew, and before long it had come time to find a larger space for their quickly expanding center, which had become a hub for Jewish life in Tining, Mumbai.
קומה רביעית רב שימושית לדירת צוות של הבית חב"ד, של המחורים, של הגננות. קומה חמישית אנחנו גרים. שישית יהיה כמין Jewish club.
אני רבקי, וכיף לראות אותך פה בבית חב"ד. משהו קר
לשתות.
זה ממש ממש חדש.
כל ערב?
כל ערב מגיעים. בדרך כלל מגיעים לפה מטיילים שעושים ערב או יומיים, מקסימום יום יומיים במומבי. מגיעים לפה הרבה יהלומנים, חבר'ה ששומרים כשרות, הרבה חרדים, הרבה דתיים בבורסה מרמת גן באים לפה. יש שבועות יותר, יש שבועות פחות, זה תלוי גם בזרימה של המטיילים.
איך זה
לחיות
בצורה כזאת שכל
זמן להעלה? זה כיף. אם הייתי גרה בארץ, אז בארץ אתה לא מארח כל יום, אבל דווקא בגלל שאני פה, אם אף אחד לא יבוא אליי, אז מה אני אעשה? לבד אני אהיה? בשביל מה באתי לפה?
אוקיי, כי זה אגדה.
פה, כי זה קשה.
לא, מתרגלים. תראי, צוות. זריזים. לומדים, האמת שהוא חדש. עובד פה רק מתחילת החודש, אבל אני כבר אלופה.
זה חופי כזה של הריח, בפתיחות.
נכון. אז אתה יודע מראש לקראת מה אתה הולך. זה העונג שלנו.
מצווים, כל אחד מצווה על אהבת ישראל. אנחנו עושים את זה לא בתור תפקיד ולא בתור זה, אנחנו כאן.
They built a mikveh to enable Jewish family life. A day camp and holiday activities became a part of their special recipe. Thousands of Torah classes were held for children and adults. For 5 years, they toiled away in distant India. On the evening of November 26, 2008, while the last of some 4,000 of their colleagues were still making their way home from a conference of Shluchim in New York, Gabi, Rifki, and their son Moshe were in the Chabad house in Mumbai. As usual, they were hosting a number of visitors, among them several tourists and kosher food supervisors from abroad. While they sat there, terrorists began to open fire at the city's main train station, then attacking hospitals and hotels near their home. 2 hours later, while Rabbi Holzberg was on the line with the Israeli consulate, terrorists began to storm the Chabad house. As they were shooting their way into the building, Rabbi Holzberg declared, "Hamatzav lo tov," the situation is not good, and the phone went dead.